All right, welcome to this segment of American Air Gunner, How It Works. I'm Rossi Morielli, and today we're gonna explore how a big blast works. So if you've ever pumped up a bike tire, an air mattress, or a ball, you've had some experience with air pressure. But first, let's consider a balloon. As you know, when it's aired up, it's pressurized. Air pressure, simply put, is the push that air has against all the surfaces that it touches. The more air there is in a contained area, the greater the pressure. Which means the air inside will have a greater pressure than the air outside of this contained area. The balloon expands as the air is pumped into it, but eventually it reaches a point where the excessive pressure causes the object containing the pressurized air to burst. Okay. So I'm gonna stop short of that and trap the pressurized air inside the balloon. The pressure of the air inside is greater than the pressure outside. So if we were to puncture this balloon, it pops. So see, the pressurized air inside suddenly expands to the level outside of the atmospheric pressure. So this rush of molecules slamming together causes that boom. So a big blast functions in much of the same way, but with plastic bottles, where the container holding the air is so much stronger, you can get more pressure into it using a pump, like these hand pumps and foot pumps and, you know, these guys that we all use, which means you're gonna get a bigger boom because you've got more pressure. So the same technology used in athletic balls, like this handy-dandy basketball right here, is used in the blast caps. A rubber port, right, is like a basketball you have right here where you place the inflator needle, goes in right like that, and you pump it up. Same thing with a blast cap. And then you can inflate these using any pump you may have in your house, a foot pump, a compressor, a little compressor, a big compressor in your garage. Just be sure you have a gauge on it so you can monitor how much air is piling up inside. Umarex has made it very easy for you. They've actually put a package together that has some big blast caps in it and this little pump. So there you go, easy enough. It has a built-in gauge so you can actually watch the pressure build up. Now every bottle has a different maximum pressure rating. You can find these on different manufacturer websites, but in general, just to be safe, it's about 80 PSI, and there is a limit that all bottles can take before they rupture, and an exploding bottle, it can be hazardous, so don't push it, and always use the little mesh net that comes with the blast caps when you're airing up. All right, so think about it. In a balloon, I could only put maybe 15 PSI in there, and when it popped, it's pretty loud, right? Well, in this bottle, you're getting 80 PSI. That's at least 65 pounds per square inch. Take the bottles you're saving for recycling, get some big blast caps from Umarex, air them up, blow them up, and then recycle them. And that's about it. You don't have to use air guns either. These things are awesome if you fill them with powder or liquids and shoot them with 22s or 9mm at range. All right, I'm out of air. Go to AmericanAirGunner.com and give us a follow on YouTube and Instagram. And if you want to see what these big blast caps can do, check this out. All right, guys, coming up, we'll take things out to the range so we can get a side-by-side comparison between a crossbow and the Air Bolt. American Air Gunner is brought to you by Big Blast Caps, Have a Blast, by Air Venturi, The Power of Air, and by Walther, Built for Life. Hey, what's up, guys? Welcome to the round table here at the range. Today, now here's the deal, the Air Bolt, right? We've seen it, 50 cal, it's the arrow. We've shot it through a van, we've shot it through a pig, it went through a ram, we've done it all. But people are still emailing and commenting like, I don't believe it's any faster than a crossbow. I don't get it. So here's what we've got. We've got the Starfire, this is a crossbow, but we're gonna kind of just show the differences of shooting a crossbow versus shooting the Air Bolt. Now, if you want to go hunt with the Air Bolt, you cannot hunt with the Air Bolt during crossbow season. So you should have both, really. But people still compare the two because that's what make sense in people's minds.
No, it's when the bomb drops and nobody has law anymore.
Got it. What should you have?
Then you take out the one that you can get things with.
There are times that you can go hunting with this anyway in any season.
Oh, sure.
Hogs, there are no seasons. Yeah. This is a hog.
Exotic game.
Yeah. Right?
Yeah.
Yeah, it's brilliant.
And it comes in other calibers now, too.
Now you're seeing, we're starting to see them in what, 45, 35, 25?
Yeah.
So a little bit of everything, completely different design, which we can't, we've talked a little bit about. We saw them at SHOT Show this year. As you can see, the actual normal knock is replaced with this.
Wow, only 223 feet per second.
223. Listen, it's an older crossbow. There are, like I said, there are newer crossbows out there that shoot like up to 450.
Yeah, mid 400s.
That are powerful.
Well, and that's the interesting thing is that when we get to the Air Bolt, the weight is significantly higher than really most of the bolts that you're going to find on the crossbow market.
Oh, real close.
227. That's what it shoots.
That's it, folks.
Okay, so there you go. There's my crossbow. Again, not the most powerful.
Okay, now I just want to be clear on something, Rossi.
Yep.
You haven't used
this before. These are fresh out of the box.
Okay.
But now you are the official liquor for the rest of the day.
Silicone grease, just so you know.
Why didn't he do that? He did it because it's hard to load any other way.
Sure.
You can use silicone grease, but that's the quick way.
All right, so we're going full power on this guy?
Full power.
Full power, open sights, fresh out of the box. Woo! A little low. Actually, very low. 449.
Now, here's the thing. Because it doesn't have the silicone grease in there, it's gonna lose a little bit.
Yeah.
Just a little bit.
So you can grease these up is what you're saying?
You're supposed to, yeah. A little bit of silicone grease on the vanes as well as on the nock there in that O-ring.
449, I mean, that's double the speed of that crossbow. And that crossbow easily takes down
Whitetail. Sure. Yeah, I mean, most of your conventional crossbows are running in like the 75 to 100 foot-pound range.
Yeah.
That shot's right around 200. It's double the energy. So it's not hard to see why you guys have been so successful with it.
This is running hotter than anything that's launched an arrow before. And you think of all the game that's been taken in Africa, the big game that's been taken here, and you think that this is more powerful. I mean, it essentially means that this is valid on any big game that's ever been taken with an arrow.
There you go, Game and Fish. Higher, Jim. 460s. Yeah, you hit the wood and you broke the arrow. Here, try one more, and let's do this at half, because you can half cock the same yang. I would like to see the difference in power. That's 467, so right now it feels like, the one thing I know about this gun, you get a max pressure, as you bring it down a little bit, the feet per second go up.
Exactly, right.
But I want to see it at a half cock, what the difference is. Higher, Jim.
I'm going higher. I'll probably shoot over the top of it this time.
467, so 385.
385.
So that's good. You're losing, I mean, you know, 80, 90 feet per second
there.
You're
down to a top crossbow.
Right.
And it's still going to help you, and you're going to be able to find it if you do miss, or it goes through the animal.
That was three shots.
Right? Yep, three
shots. All right, let's go take a look. So this one low.
Oh, no, this is good. Here, check this out.
He nailed the board.
Through the target. Yeah.
Three-piece of plywood.
Through the target, 3 pieces of plywood.
And there you go, my friend. That is why the Air Bolt is better than any other arrow bolt, even a bolt of lightning, I think it has more power. I'm not for sure, don't quote me on this, but you know what, I'm just gonna say it's alternate facts. It has more power than a lightning bolt.
Where's Shazam when you need him?
It's better. It's time to wrap up our coverage of the